XFM News. On point. The news on XFM. I'm Chris Tim. Police have completed investigations of the 22 people who died during the Free Bobi Wine riots, whose families shall be compensated. 54 people died as security was dispersing rioters in different parts of the country, and the Ugandan president ordered for the compensation of the innocent lives that were lost. The police spokesperson, Fred Enanga, says that they have compiled the list and forwarded the files to the Prime Minister and the Minister for Kampala for due diligence to follow up on the families.
We compiled the list and forwarded to the two offices, the office of the Prime Minister and also the Minister for Kampala. They are fast tracking. We availed them the particulars of the victims. It is their duty now to ensure that they get to these families.
Enanga further explains about the six other suspects connected to the riots.
Regarding the ballistics report, yes, a director of forensics managed to retrieve four guns over the weekend for comparison. That one is also another bit of expansion in the investigations. There were six other arrests which were made during the course of the week, which brings the number of arrested persons to 1,110.
Winnie Kiza, the national campaign coordinator for presidential candidate General Mugisha Muntu of the Alliance for the National Transformation, has described unfairness in the scientific elections. Kiza says they have found it hard to have access to different media houses in the places they have been campaigning because they are booked by the ruling NRM party and others are expensive. She adds that most radio stations are owned by NRM leaders who find it hard to host the opposition candidates.
It's not an easy campaign. Majority of the candidates are using the radio stations and there are no opposition people owning radio houses. So really going to an NRM person's radio, it's not easy. Sometimes if they give you the time, they will inflate the figures, the amount of money requested from you, and you see that it is too much, you can't afford. So you just chase yourself, but you know that they did it intentionally to stop you from using the radio.
Independent presidential candidate Kizza Joseph Kabuleta has postponed his campaigns in the greater Masaka. Kabuleta was scheduled to campaign in Masaka, Luengo, Chotira and Rakai yesterday as well as today. According to his campaign manager, Masiko Godwin Mwezi, Kabuleta plans to reschedule his campaigns in these districts with the Electoral Commission. Masiko says that Kabuleta could not make it because of some unfinished business that could not enable him to travel.
Joseph Kabuleta will be rescheduling his engagements in Masaka, Chotera, Rakai and Rengo, which was he will be working with the Electoral Commission for clearance on which other days he should be able to make it and will inform the media accordingly.
Now in world news, the first people in the UK are expected to receive a coronavirus vaccine later as a rollout of the Pfizer-BioNTech jab begins in what is being called the V-Day. About 70 hospital hubs in the UK are gearing up to vaccinate the over 80s and some health and care staff. It marks the start of a mass program aiming to protect the most vulnerable and return life to normal. More than 60,000 people in the UK have died after being infected with COVID, according to government figures. The UK will be the first country in the world to start using the vaccine after regulators approved its use last week. Vaccination will not be compulsory. In sports news, Paul Pogba is unhappy at Manchester United and has to change teams in the next transfer window, says his agent, Mino Raiola. The France midfielder's current contract runs until June of 2022. 27-year-old Pogba, who is originally from Guinea, has made only 8 Premier League appearances this season, starting 5 and scored his first goal of the campaign last Saturday. Paul is unhappy. He is no longer able to express himself as he would like and as expected of him, his agent Raiola said. And that's the latest XFM News.
XFM News. On point.